because I think that in living in the States, you're living in one of the most brutal societies in the history of the world. You know, the country who inherited the genocide of the Native American peoples. A country which participated in chattel slavery. You know, the only country in the world to use and drop an atomic bomb on another country society. The country which murdered and enslaved millions in Southeast Asia as a result of the Vietnam War. And we drew from the people who resisted. We were inspired because we feel that any society or any government or any system that is set up solely to profit a wealthy class, while the majority of the people toil and suffer and sell their labor power, so long as that system's only true motive is profit interest and not the maintenance. Well, because I think that in living in the States, you're living in one of the most brutal societies in the history of the world. You know, the country who inherited the genocide of the Native American peoples. A country which participated in chattel slavery. You know, the only country in the world to use and drop an atomic bomb on another country society. The country which murdered and enslaved millions in Southeast Asia. I was drawn to music really, really early in my life. I don't know whether I had friends who were older than me who turned me on to different things. I think initially I was listening to, like, Hendrix. I was listening to a little bit of jazz. I was listening to Charlie Parker at a very young age, and I was just drawn to it. I started playing guitar at first, because my first instrument I played. Later, I think it was just an instinctual thing. You know, there was I grew up in a very, I was a Mexicano in a part of the country where I was the exception to the rule, because most Mexicanos in Orange County were there because they had a broom or a hammer in their hand and were picking baskets of strawberries, you know. So this is, I had a deep sense of frustration, alienation I experienced growing up in a very conservative community, very racist. Forces within the global economy, it really, the title actually came from a speech given by Ronald Reagan in the 1980s, as he addressed the Soviet Union as the evil empire. And if you look at the atrocities committed by the U.S. in the latter half of the 20th century, that name, we figured that name or that tag could easily be used to describe the U.S.